Today we will start chapter number 3, function. Chapter number 2 we have covered earlier. You can see my previous video. Now chapter number 3 is function. Before starting this chapter, we need to understand what is a function. Function is the act on a data and often return a value. Means it is act like a data and always return a value. That is known as a function. Let's take an example. Can something, okay? This can something is a kind of function which we put over here and the variable we have given x, okay? Now, this function will return this value, r equals to 2 into x into x. So, it will return what? It will return r. So, as I clear by the help of definition, that function means return a value. So, definitely whatever the function we will put over here, that will give some return value. If it is not giving a return value, it is not a function. Keep in mind this thing. The function means you need a return value. Earlier we are doing the print. We are passing the print over here, but in case of function, we will pass the return. Return is a kind of function, okay, which is only used for the function using. Next is second. Like another function, I have taken a cube function. In a cube function, I have again passed one parameter that is known as x, and after that I have given one variable res which is having x multiplied by 3. So this is a kind of function which gives the again return value. So the function means return a value, so it will again return res. So one function is cube is required. So x multiplied by 3 in the case of this one, and afterward we write the 3, because the cube value is 3. Cube means just 3 values, so it will be multiplied by 3. If it is with sqrt, means square multiplied by 2. Okay. Next means whatever power you want to execute, you want x to power 4, so you will write like this way, x power 4, x power 5 like this way, means whatever power you write, you just write after whatever the parameter you are using, that parameter and whatever the number you are using for that support power. Okay. Next, types of function. This thing is very seriously you have to understand what is the meaning of function. Function means types of function. First is built-in function. Built-in function means inbuilt function. Inbuilt means, as the name clear itself, already built function. Okay, that you can see inside a Python. That for an example, if I have taken that kind of print. Print is a kind of the built-in function. When we put this function, then only output will come. Okay, now the next function is like if I said in. Input. This is a kind of function. When we put this function, then only we can give the value on runtime. So this is a kind of function. Okay. Now next is function defined in modules. How we can define function in modules? We can define function in module by passing small parameter. So we can know that how can we define this particular modules. Like small statement we can pass so that we can write the modules function. Okay. Next is user defined function. This function is like that when we use, like whatever we want to make, according to our choice we made some function, like get function we are making when we want a get function, like append function we are making put the value in the last. So that kind of function which is user make according to your desire. If you are according to your desire you are making some function, that is known as a user defined function. I am giving you a lot of example of user defined function. Like user defined function, another example if I am giving you, so in this we can use the function first, get function. Second, like it would be put sum x and y. Okay, sum and x y. This term is a kind of function which tells to the computer that we have going this value add, because this we have passed in a parameter. So this we need to be add. For adding instead of plus function, plus operation, we are using the function sum over here. So this is a kind of function which is made, okay, and which we made, that is known as a user defined function. Okay. Now next is how to we will do as a queue. Next is I am applying multiple times of them. How does, let us suppose I have taken one example sum, okay, where we pass one parameter and variable. Where we are giving in the sign, we need to understand what this function is going to do. This function is going to do, this n is a number of limitation which you are giving on run times, so whatever the value you are given, that will terminate one by one. Okay, so let us suppose I have given n value is 7, okay. Then we are not supposed to put over here range, so that means the original value will pass again and again. So what should be the passing value is 7 multiplied by 1 plus 7 multiplied by 2 plus 7 multiplied by 3. This passing value and become s. S is print. Now s is print, but print statement is not used as a function. So what we will write instead of this, we will write return. As I told you, return required for output, as a print required for the output, in the case of function, return required for the output. Next is adding function. How can we add the function? Like how many function you want to add? That is, suppose I want to add three function, sum x and y. So sum is another function, this is what function number one. And this, here we are doing the multiplying of numbers. So we use a mult function. Here we write subtraction of the function. We use the this one. So that does mean only, sorry, in the case of subtraction you have to write the whole one. In the case of subtraction you have to write the whole one so that it will come. Okay, sum, that subtraction x into y. So this we can see we have used the three function one by one. This is function number 1, this is function number 2 and function number 3. This we can use more, so we can understand that more than one function we can use in a one program. And as you can see, this is a user defined function. We define according to the our choice, according to the asked demand of the program. We use the sum function, multiplying, subtraction, and if we make the division, also it is kind of the calculator function. Means in calculation we have sum, multiplying, subtraction and dividation. So we can understand, we can put more than one function in a one program. Next, how to call the function. Now how the function is occurred? Function occurred two times. First was the function call and the second was the function. First is a call by value and another one is call by reference. This is two type of function is present. One is call by value function and another one is call by reference function. First we will need to understand what is a function call, then we will understand what is a call by value and what is call by reference. Function call, a term clear, it's a calling function. Means somewhere we are putting a program and for that program we are making another function which call that upper function to down. Like this, I made one program, okay, I put here function, okay, now return this function over here. Program is seen because return is there, and after that again I am calling this function over here. How? Until let us suppose sum equals to x and y. Clear? Now what you will do according to this line, you will write return sum. Clear? Next, according to this line, we have again sum is the same amount. Function name should be same. Okay, always remind the same. When you call your function, function name, never you can give another one. You have to give the same name. Okay? So I was using earlier sum. Sum is a function one. So again, but you can change the parameter you are passing. X and Y, instead of that, L into Y. But the function is same. As he is doing the sum of X and Y, as he is doing the function of L and Y. And then we return the statement. Or instead of this, in a function second, And instead of the function second, we write print. Print is also a command which is used for the sum. So in this case, we can see that our function, this is a how to function call. That first we put the sum function over here, and after that we call this function over here. But what we change? We change only the parameter. Earlier it was x and y, now it was l by y. But the function is same. Okay. Now, next program I am going to tell you where we have inherit the function. Okay. Same sum x and y we have used. Small operation I have performed, x plus y, and afterward I return this particular value. But program is not going to be here over here. Program is here. Now again you have put the num1 and num2 value, which you are giving a run time. Okay. After that, again we have put sum equals to sum plus num1 and num2 and print sum. Then can you see the difference between both of the program? Here we change the function. Here is x and here is, instead of x, is sum. So we can say that this function is not correlated with this function, because this is a different, and we know according to the definition of function, a function should return a value. Here the value is not returned, hello. And earlier I told you, if a value is not returned, so we can use the same function, but the function name is not same and the value is not returned. So this program is not correlated with this program. In this way we can do the output question. Some like in a board examination, examiner is asking some output like question. In output like question, is asking this is similarity between this function. There is a function called use, where is not use. So you can see here is not a use, because this function is not called by this. If the name is same, it is over there. So we can say the function is same. Next is multiple function causes. Now multiple function causes may be used. The one function A into B, according to the program you can see it's here, A into B, and after that y equals to 3 we have taken. Up we need to understand different line means. We have taken, this is simply A and B, and we are going to multiply A and B. What is this line mean? Y is the value which is having 3, and then multiply 12 into y. So how its function? 12 and 3 means we multiply by 12 into 3. What is this function will do? Again, whatever the value will come is stored in mult. So again we are doing y into y means here function statement number second, it will give 3, 3. What it will give over here? It will give y value is 3 and x value is 5. So this is the output like question, where example give you a whole program and ask you what is the statement output one by one. So we need to understand, examiner will give you this kind of a program and give you this value also. You have to write one by one value and write the one by one output. Next, passing parameter. This is a main important role of function, how to passing a parameter. Okay, without parameter passing, the function is not be a possible. Okay, like if I return function and I have passed two values x and y over here. So that means this value can be called. If value is not inside these parentheses, please pay attention about these parentheses. This is a parenthesis. This is a parenthesis, and where we pass two values x and y. So that means parentheses are required and passing argument are required. This is the passing argument which is going to be a call by another function. Okay, this is very important when we want to call some function. Like if you are using, earlier I told you example of function 1, function 2, function 3, where you can understand the function 1 and function 2 and function 3 are calling one by one variable again. So that is mean x and y means we are putting some function over here, and this simply inside the parenthesis means this is known as a passing argument. This is a passing parameter or okay. So we can say our first variable is ch and the value is x, y and z, and the another one is s, which is having passing values w and x, and also I told you with the help of example. next program. This is now I would like to tell you whole program so that you understand what we did. Find the principal amount. Okay, now define interest. A simple program where we find out how to find out the principal. We have given interest over here and give the formula. Principal multiplied by rate multiplied by time. PRT, as we know, PRT is a simple interest formula which we taken out how to write. And in this way, we have written the value here. Means one program is going to end over here. Okay, now another one. What is the meaning of this main again and again? Main again and again means when we correlate the function 1 to function 2, we require to put the main function. Okay, if the main function will be there, then only we know that this program is going to be a correlate with this program. Next is, we again input all the value like principal, again interest. Here, please come here, this rate and again time. We have taken. Now see, how many functions are required? One statement is here, and one statement is here. The three statements are here. So you can see how many types of argument is going to be a pass. One is here, second is here, and third is here. But agenda is same. We have to find out the only principal amount, principal rate and time. So the three things we are giving on runtime, because we will want to give this value on runtime. So we will write like float in this way and float again in this way, and for the timing we write instead of float in, because timing never comes from that one passes. Okay, now again you can see the answer is coming in three variables. First answer is coming over here because simply we are not giving third variables, we are putting the formula simply. And the next one we are want this value in S1, and this S1, that's another passing parameter is SI2. So the function is say the three functions are there. The answer will be once time only. Answer will not come three times. Answer will come one time only. Okay. So this one we can see if this is a kind of the function invoking. Function ke andar function work kar raha hai, that is known as a function invoking. And this is the function third, means it will relate all the function to each other. In this way we understand how the function works. Okay. Again I am repeating all the things. What is a function? We need to understand functions act like a data which always gives return a value. Need to understand this return a value, if it is not there, that means that is not a function. Okay. So small function I have put it over here and calculate the function, and then again I am telling you the cube function and the type of function. Again I am telling you built-in function means whatever function is used already defined in a computer. Means when the Python is supposed to be a design, then already defined by the designer, that function is known as a built-in function. And function defined modules means we are giving some kinds of modules, like we want to find out the sign, we want to find out the cause. So this is the value of the modules, small modules. When we divide a function in a small modules. The third function is user defined according to the demand of the questions. When we make some function, that is known as a user defined function. Okay. Now again, this you can see a simple program where I am giving you n value and multiplied on them. And add function means function invoking to second and invoking to three. Okay. Sum, multiply, subtraction. Okay. This one program we can use more than one function. This program I will tell you in the second next video of this chapter. Okay. Now the function call is call by value. As I told you, this is the two parts: call by value and call by reference. Okay. Call by value means we are giving some function. So in a case of call by value, again I am telling you, function name should be same in case of call by value. Okay. So same sum equals to x y, we passing some argument, and then sum l into y. We replace this l to x, replace this y into, again we can change the value. So we need to understand some function is doing. In the case of this, we will type the w. So matlab in the place of y we type the w. So this we can see the change of the program. Now this is simple. I told you this is not correlated program. Some output type of question examiner will ask you. This is 2 marks question. Examiner will give you a whole program. It will ask ki where the function is occur, where the function is not occur. So just see the function. I am telling you a key keep going, just see the function, please remind where the return is. If the return is there, that means function is there. Okay? The next is multiple function. We are using some kind of the output question. Y ki value 3 hai, then we have given some value over here. Wherever the x value is given, we have put some value over there. And next, passing parameter. Again, I am telling you the things which is inside the parenthesis is known as a parameter. Like here, we are giving x, y, z, the three kind of the argument which is passing inside the parenthesis. And here, we give two a kind of argument which is inside the parenthesis. So, this is known as a parameter. When it comes to argument, when we supposed to give the value inside this, that is known as a argument passing. I am giving you an example also so that you understand what is the argument and what is the parameter. Like suppose here I have given SEH equals to XYZ. So we can give the value inside 7 and Y value 8 and Z value is 11. Whatever you want. So this is the kind of the argument which is passing inside a parameter. Okay? When you are supposed to give the value also, whatever the variable we define, earlier we gave in a runtime, but if you want to give inside a program, we can give inside a parenthesis. Okay, so this is a passing parameter and this is the whole program where we correlate how to return a value S1 and S2. So this is the end of the function. Okay, again in next video, I will tell you how to use the call by reference. Thank you.